a selfless devotion to serving the poor and expanding our Franciscan order. Benedict invites people from all backgrounds to reflect on his teaching of humility, compassion, and environmental stewardship, inspiring us to live a life of peace and working towards all living beings. Join us in commemorating St. Francis Day as we delve into the profound wisdom and spirituality of this remarkable saint. sexuality and faith to movement and expression. In many cultures, prayer dance are an integral part of religious rituals and ceremonies. Preserving tradition and heritage, now let's start this program with graceful prayer dance.
like emotions, tell a story, or simply celebrate music. Dance exists in various styles and cultures worldwide, from ballet and hip-hop to traditional folk dances, offering a diverse and rich means of human creativity and communication. Please welcome our little champs for their beautiful dance performance.
Thank you.
letter-wise, the deeper meaning. Secondly, people use music as a painkiller to escape from the pain of life. Musical location is leading from there. So please welcome our actors with their meaningful drama act.
Now what color do you want to paint our birdhouse?
How about white?
Then the birds can see through the night too.
Okay, that's a good idea, Jim. Come on, let's start painting.
I hope the parrots, sparrows and the other birds come to live here too.
Wow, that was a good thought, Jim. You know, I like birds so much.
It would be great to see all the birds flying around in our garden.
Well, I was thinking how this world would have looked like if there were no animals and birds.
That would have been very boring.
Hey Jim, did you know that there is a patron saint for animals and nature?
Who? Patron saint for animals and birds? Who is it, Joanne?
It's St Francis of Assisi. He is considered as the patron saint for birds and animals.
Well, Joanne, I have an idea. Let's ask Uncle Francis to tell us the story of St. Francis today.
That's a great idea, Jim.
Good morning, Uncle Francis.
Good morning, children. What were you doing this morning?
Uncle, we are making a birdhouse.
And we planted a tree in our garden.
Great job, children. I was thinking of telling you the story of the patron saint of birds and animals. Do you know who he is?
What a coincidence! Joanne told me about the patron saint. Isn't it Francis of Assisi?
Wow, that's great, Joan.
Yes, Uncle Francis. We were discussing about St. Francis of Assisi while we were making the birdhouse.
Very good, Joan. Then let me tell you the story of this great saint. A long, long time ago, in a little city known as Assisi in Italy, there lived a young boy named Francis Bernardo. Francis lived with his father and mother who loved him very much. Francis's father was one of the richest men in Assisi, and he made sure that Francis got everything he needed. He used to tell great tales of brave warriors every day. Francis loved these stories, and as he listened to his father, he longed to become a great knight someday. Francis grew up, and he made friends with the sons of the richest men in Assisi. Everybody liked Francis, as he could sing, dance, and above all, he used to spend plenty of money at parties.
Ha ha! That is great fun today, my friends.
Yes, my friend. We meet tomorrow as well.
Good night, everyone. Oh no, it's so late. Mother will be waiting for me. I must reach home quickly.
Huh?
My son, stop, please.
Huh? Who was that?
My son, I haven't eaten anything all day. Can you please give me some money to buy food?
What? Do you know who I am? I'm the son of the richest man in Assisi. How dare you stop me like this?
I'm so sorry. I didn't know who you were. I was hungry. Sorry. Please forgive me.
Stupid old fool.
Huh?
No, I shouldn't have talked to him like that.
Hello, stop. Please wait.
What happened, son?
Huh? I'm sorry for what I said. I shouldn't have spoken to you like that.
That's all right, son. I hear that every time.
Here, please take this. I don't want you to sleep on an empty stomach tonight.
Huh? Thank you, my son. You're so kind.
You should get something to eat. I have to leave now.
The people who were close to Francis knew that, however careless he was, he always had a kind heart. In a few years, the war broke out, and Francis soon had a chance to be a soldier and fight the war.
Please, my son, please don't leave. You know how much we love you.
You don't have to do this, my son.
Father, you know that I have always longed to become a knight.
But I have always wanted you to be a merchant. Everything I have earned is for you.
I know, Father, but please let me do what I want. I love being a soldier.
All right, my son, if that's what you wish.
Thank you, Father. Thank you so much.
Come back soon, my love.
And so, at the age of 19, Francis joined the army and went to war against the nearby town of Perugia. The war lasted for many days, and Francis fought bravely. But the side that Francis fought for started losing, and eventually he was surrounded by the enemies.
Hallelujah. God. Huh? Was it real? Or am I just dreaming?
The visions he received made Francis a reformed person. Francis returned home after a few days, but he kept receiving these visions from God. He now wore ordinary clothes, and he stayed away from lavish parties with friends. Instead of his love for leading a soldier's life, a new love was born in his heart, a love for all the hungry and sick people in the world.
Hello, brother. How are you feeling?
Huh? Are you not Francis? Son of Pietro the silk merchant?
Yes, I am, sir. I was born as a privileged person, but now I see Jesus in you.
Oh, what a surprise! Strange are the ways of the Lord.
Okay, brother. I will come and meet the other people staying in your colony. I hope I can be of service to you.
It seemed to him that he must go everywhere and tell everyone to love one another. Francis spent most of his time praying in mountain highways and in the churches nearby. One day, he received another vision from God.
Lord, if that's your will.
Not fully understanding the word of the Lord, Francis thought that his mission was to repair the churches which were in poor condition. So he sold his clothes and his father's horse to collect money for repairing the church. This really angered his father, and he took him to the Bishop of Assisi.
Your Excellency, I think my son has driven insane. What makes you think I'm the Pietro? He has stolen all of my suit clothes and even my horse for the sake of repairing some churches. Is this allegation true, Francis?
Your Excellency, I have been entrusted with a mission by the Lord to rebuild the churches.
But my son, we are here to do that. Why do you want to spend your father's money for that?
But Your Excellency, who gave my father this wealth? God has given, and I have taken for the sake of God.
See? Did I tell you that he has turned mad? Young gentleman, what you're saying may be correct, but you need to return the money to your father, as you have done this without his permission.
All right, Your Excellency. If you say so, I'm willing to give back his money. I will also return the clothes I wear, which was also bought with my father's money.
Why our school is
name, St. Francis. Today, when you are looking on the stage, different programs, the difficult, the life history of St. Francis. Just now, Salih has spoke in great length about the life history of St. Francis. Let me ask you some questions pertaining to the speech that was being said here, and you have witnessed the different programs, especially the skit, began with the two persons having conversation here from house was made, okay? Then they wanted to break it. So they start with it. So each color.
Scientist, then he will have two, three answers. One is
finance means money. Second is respect in the society. Third is a humanitarian service. Three aspects. When you see the history of St. Francis, he also was same there. He wanted to become a knight. Knight means a soldier, an army officer. Because those times, that was a very high profile job. Become an army officer, it was a high profile job. But the course of time, he changed his mind. Because nobody is born as a saint. He become saint. So in the life of Francis also, he was born in a rich family those days. His father was a silk merchant and plenty.
Thank you. For making this event a grand success. At last, I end my work.